We're here at the MSU Post Farm west of Bozeman to test infiltration rates on the same soil type but under different management. These plots are all Amsterdam silt loams and they've been managed in a dryland crop system study for almost 20 years. The average annual precip here at this site is 14 inches. If you have better infiltration, that means your rainfall is more likely to go into your soil rather than sit on top of your soil and either evaporate or run off. The first plot we're going to test is a tilled wheat fallow system. For our next test, we're going to test infiltration in a no-till continuous wheat system. So I've got an infiltration ring here, 6 inches in diameter and it's 6 inches deep. And I'm going to pound it into the ground to the 3-inch mark. So I put down 3 inches of water into this cylinder to saturate the soil. Now let's go ahead and take an infiltration rate. So our final rates are tilled wheat fallow can infiltrate water at a rate of 3.1 inches per hour. And right next door, our no-till continuous wheat can infiltrate water at a rate of 50.4 inches per hour. Quite a difference. Let's compare these two soils side by side. In this hand, I have the no-till continuous crop. And in this hand, I have the tilled crop fallow. Notice all the structure and the small aggregates that are in this soil. That makes it more porous and has better water infiltration, and the roots can grow and flourish in this soil as compared to this one. We just don't have a lot of aggregation, not a lot of soil structure. It's hard to move air and water through this, and it's hard to move roots through this as well. This soil structure is what makes the difference for the infiltration rates that we saw today. We know that if we can follow the 5 soil health principles, we're going to have less runoff and more infiltration into our soils.